Merry Christmas, everyone, and thanks for joining me here on WMUR's Weather on the Web. I'm meteorologist Bill Gile. Here's your forecast for your Christmas Day. We have cold air in place across the New England states, and it extends all the way back through the Midwest and into the Upper Plains. This little slice of Arctic air is only staying north of the White Mountains. We're going to be seeing temperatures just seasonably cold in the Manchester area and through the Lakes region over the next couple of days, and there won't be a lot of deviation in our temperatures from day to day. Down to the south, warm and humid air. And when you have a collision of air masses occurring in a nearby region, relatively nearby, you get some sort of storm development. And that is occurring now. As we go through the day today, we're going to be watching low pressure cut across Texas, gain a lot of energy out of the Gulf of Mexico region. And you can see from this morning, severe thunderstorms beginning to erupt in northeast Louisiana, heading into Mississippi. It'll be going into Alabama, Tennessee, and Arkansas during the course of the day today, and the potential is there for tornadic development, so we'll be keeping an eye out on that. And along the eastern seaboard, very little weak system, and that's our Christmas morning snow that's going to race on by and come to an end for the afternoon for us. And then now out on the west coast, that's our next potential weather system for next weekend, and that's a long way away, and that storm track could certainly deviate quite a bit, so we're not going to focus much on that other than to alert you to the fact there may be something in that point in time. But this will be the one that we'll really be watching as it gets towards the mid-Atlantic coastline. But for now, we're dealing with our Christmas morning snow that's basically been working through the region and having an awful difficult time getting down to the surface in the overnight hours. But it finally managed to do so just prior to daybreak, and we're seeing some light snow that's going to continue into the morning. First little batch going on by, the second one's going to rotate in, but tend to weaken a little bit as it does, and it's only going to last until about noon or 1 o'clock, and it's all essentially done. As you watch our future cast, doesn't put out a whole lot of precipitation at all. Snowfall amounts basically are going to be a dusting to an inch out of this, but it's enough where it does fall to make untreated surfaces slippery. So if you are traveling to a destination, relatives, or anywhere this morning and into the afternoon, be aware of that. Anything that's untreated is going to be slick. High temperatures today topping off into the 30s, low and mid-30s, with some sunshine developing later in the afternoon before sunset, and it stays cold off to the north country, where it'll be in the low to mid-20s for highs. Skies do clear out tonight. Readings fall into the single digits and teens from north to south. So, yes, indeed, a very chilly night tonight. And, again, here's our snow totals that we'll be seeing across the region. In most areas, it's just going to be a dusting, but a few spots could get a half inch to an inch tops, and that's the way it looks at this point in time. All right, now as we go through the day on Wednesday, a good deal of sunshine. Some high clouds come in for the afternoon. Temperatures 26 to 36 degrees. We'll be already starting to see some snow work into Pennsylvania, and that is going to be heading in our direction for Wednesday night and on into Thursday. Here's how it's all going to evolve. We'll watch the storm cut across the Gulf of Mexico region during the course of the day today, and as it does so, gaining a lot of energy and moisture as well, and then carrying that towards the mid-Atlantic coast for tomorrow, reforming a new storm right along the eastern seaboard for Wednesday afternoon and evening. And that is the key to our forecast. Exactly where does that form? And it does look like, by most of our computer models, that it's going to be what we call a coastal hugger, meaning it's going to come right up along the coastline and cut across Long Island Sound and perhaps go through Cape Cod and the islands for Wednesday night and on into Thursday. So that track would get us starting as snow, perhaps becoming a heavy, wet, pasty snow for a while, and then transitioning to a mix of sleet and freezing rain, at least in southern New Hampshire, and perhaps even some plain rain right towards the coast and into southern New England. So we'll see how that all plays out. But right now, based on that line of thinking, the potential is there for a heavy snow event, especially to the north. But where we get this icy mix occurring, it'll be light amounts of snow, maybe something on the order of 2 to 4 inches, could be a little bit more depending on how long it does snow and when that transition takes place. Certainly lesser amounts toward the coast where there'll be some change to rain perhaps. But otherwise, You move to the interior just a bit, and it's a moderate snowfall because it will snow, or at least look like it's going to, moderate to heavy at times. So Concord to the upper valley could get moderate snows, and we're talking 6 inches, maybe a little bit more. And then up in ski country, this is where I really see the jackpot occurring. Great news for skiers, and I can easily see a foot falling in those locations from this event should it stay mainly snow in those areas. As we go through the day again, for the next couple of days, some brightening after some light snow this morning, quiet day tomorrow, and then it's also going to be a windy storm event on Thursday, so we'll be keeping tabs on that. We'll be defining it a little bit better over the next day or so. And then Friday, quiet again, increasing clouds Saturday afternoon could lead to another storm into Sunday. That's your latest forecast. Have a Merry Christmas, everyone. Thanks for joining me here on WMUR.com.